9, as we have started the chapter packing yesterday. So what this chapter is about, it's about the, you can say, packing skills of a person. Okay. So through this chapter, the writer Jerem K. Jerem, he is displaying the effective fact that packing is not a frivolous activity, useless activity. Of course, it requires skills also, complete planning, adequate planning, as well as efficiency of a person. So from the very first paragraph, when we have read this chapter, what we have come to know about the three friends. So what kind of nature they have? They were not at all bothered. Okay. So what was the reaction shown by his two friends when the author or when the narrator, he announces that he's to do all the packing. So what he has said? They were quite comfortable with each other also, right? Okay. And ultimately, what was the main thing or what was the one thought that often haunts the narrator? That about his toothbrush. Okay. So what experience he has shared, Jasroop will tell me. Jasroop, yes. What experience he has shared about his toothbrush problem? What he has told? Will you be able to tell? Sit down then. Next, Eva, yes. What he has told about his toothbrush? And this idea often haunts him. He used to forget it to pack, and on the days of his, you can say, journey, he would rush upstairs, go to upstairs in order to get it. And finally, he wrapped it in the handkerchief, slid it into his pocket and would go on to his journey. Okay. And why did his friend Harris did not made him point out or did not point him that he hasn't packed the boots? Why? He was unbothered by the packing. Moreover, he wanted to torture him, irritate him because he's doing the packing alone. Okay. So he must have noticed that throughout the time he was packing the boots inside, but still he has not mentioned it to him. Right. So this is all. So finally, coming up to para 6, this we have to start today. So of course, I had to turn every mortal thing out now. And of course, mortal thing here refers to ordinary thing. Every mortal thing out now. And of course, I could not find it. What he said, I had to take out each and everything out of my bag. Okay, finally. But he said I was not able to find it. I rummaged, means searched. Rummaged means searched. I rummaged the things up into much the same state that they must have been before the world was created and when chaos reigned. So he said that I searched each and everything so that everything that was seen to be at, you can say, incomplete order, that seems to be completely in chaos because everything messed up, everything mixed up. Okay, earlier he has done it with quite, you can say, packing that he has done. It was with great, you can say care. Okay, he has done it with great care in an organized manner. But now when he was searching for it, he has taken all the things and they have been mixed up. Again, he has to put his again efforts. Of course, I found George and Harris 18 times over, but I couldn't find my own. He said, when I was searching for the things for George and Harris, I found it 18 times. Means again and again, I'm coming to the site of their toothbrush. But he said, where is mine? I didn't find it. I put the things back one by one and held everything up and shook it. Then I found it inside a boot and I repacked once more. So this is the second time he has packed it. He said, I searched for it at each and every point. Finally, like he was shaking the things in this manner. Kahin iske andar to nahi hai, kahin iske andar to nahi hai. Okay, right. He was trying to do it. And finally, what has happened? Finally, he has found it inside a boot. And then he has packed it again. So When I had finished, George asked if the soap was in. Now see, see his friend. When he has packed again all the things, his friend said, oh, have you packed the soap? No. Naturally, he would get irritated. I said I didn't care to care a hang whether the soap was in or whether it wasn't. And I slammed the bag shut and strapped it. He said, no, I don't care now whether the soap is in or not, because I have put in much hard efforts, very, you can say, with much labor, I have done all the packing. And now at the last moment, you are again telling me whether I have packed the soap in. I have opened it at once from my boots. And then I have, this is third, okay, second time for my toothbrush. And now you are saying for soap, he said, no, I don't care about it. And found that I had packed my spectacles in it. And finally, when he has packed the bag, what thought he has got, he came to know that he has packed his spectacles in it. Now he has to, okay, and he had to reopen it. See, okay, it got shut up finally at 10:05 p.m. So finally, at the end, he has completed his packing at 10:05 p.m. And then there remain the hampers to do. Then ultimately, hampers means the small bags, handbags, or you can say the polythene ones, where some essentialities of immediate need, they can be packed. Okay, so that they need not to open up the bag. Okay, some small things they have to pack. These hampers were left only. Harris said that we should be wanting to start in less than 12 hours time, and thought that he and George had better to do the rest. And I agreed and sat down, and they had a go. So finally, Harry said that now there's not much time, only 12 hours left. And during that time, we have to take sleep also. And finally, what they said, George and Harry said, okay, fine, you have done the packing of the bag. And now what I have to do, let me do the packing of the hampers. It means that George and Harris, what they will do, they will pack the hampers. And finally, because he was tired of his packing, unpacking again and again, so finally what he did, he said, okay, finally, you will carry on. And he sat down. Now, let us see. So now this one part is over, okay, in which we have come to know that how Jerem, he has packed the bag. Okay, so from what is your opinion about his packing skills? Chaotic person. Okay, he has short memory also. Okay, you can say worried nature also. This is the reason why he was again and again worried about his toothbrush. He was having an haunting idea about his toothbrush, right? Okay, so for this reason, so finally he was tired and he said, okay, fine, now I'll stop packing. And now the hampers were left. Okay, so now for the hampers, ultimately, George and Harris, they started. They began in a light-hearted spirit. So how they have started? In a light-hearted manner, least bothered about the thing and least bothering which things to be packed before. Okay, suppose you have to pack some things. You have got some bottle of jam, some tomatoes, some vegetables, and some soft toys. So how you will pack them? If I will ask you, how you will pack them? Dia will not answer me. Now rest of the students. Yes, these two lines. How you will pack them? Suppose I have given you a bottle of jam, bottle of tomato ketchup, some tomatoes, some other vegetables. Okay. Okay, good. This is I'm asking how in an organized manner. Suppose you are given these items, like he is saying that वैसे absolutely right. Otherwise, what sir? हाँ? क्या? No, there is no provision because they are going on a journey to a river. Okay, so there is no provision. There is no shop. This is the reason they are going to have all everything with them. There is a movie also in Three Men in a Boat. Okay, you can search it. Lighter ones you will pack at the top. So now let us see what they are going to do. So they began in a light-hearted spirit, evidently intending to show me how to do it. So ultimately, what kind of intention they have? Actually, they wanted to show him, you have done an ultimate chaos. You have created a lot of chaos. Now let us show you that how to do it. But sometimes, in order to outshine others, outshine means to let others down. Sometimes you also turn out to be the victim of that. So let us see, this also happens with them also. So ultimately, they were trying to show him that you have made an utter chaos. And now we will tell you how to do it. I made no comment. He was silent. I only waited. He has followed the policy of just wait and watch. And I think this is the best one when someone is trying to do so. And because ultimately the circumstances will ultimately teach a lesson to a person. With the exception of George, Harris is the worst packer in this world. So this is the opinion of the narrator. What he said, that Harris is the worst packer, and this he has given, underline it, he has given his opinion on the basis of his previous experience, right? He has given this on the basis of his previous experience. And I looked at the piles of plates, cups, kettles, bottles, jars, pies, stoves, cakes, and tomatoes, etc., and felt that the thing would soon become exciting. So imagine this scene. They were sitting on the floor with hampers, 3 or 4 hampers, and on the side, number of things, piles of plates, then cups. One was lying down, one was arranged one, okay? And then kettles, bottles, jars, pies, softer ones, okay? Soft thing to eat, stoves, cakes, tomatoes. And now he knew, now the thing is really going to be exciting, because he knew Harris is the worst packer, and definitely he will make something, or he will do a mistake. He will commit a mistake. It did. Of course it did. Then what happened? They started with breaking a cup. Okay. So the first thing when they were doing was they broke a cup. That was the first thing they did. They did that just to show you what they could do and to get you interested. Actually, what he said, that why they did that, in order to show you, yes, this is also another thing that we can do. Okay. To make someone interested means actually it is his viewpoint. Means deliberately they haven't broken a cup. Deliberately means knowingly they haven't. It was accidental. Okay, but what he said is actually they wanted to show that yes, we can do this also. Okay, ultimately to interest somebody else. Then Harris packed the strawberry jam on top of a tomato and squashed it. See, you can say lack of common sense. And they had to pick out the tomato with a teaspoon. Imagine. What Harris did, he has put the tomatoes over it. He has put the bottles of strawberry jam, and finally, tomatoes, they squashed. The juice of the tomato, it oozed out. And finally, they have to clean it. Finally, they were picking up the tomato with the help of teaspoon. Imagine, this is one humorous instance. And then it was George's turn. And he trod on the butter. I didn't say anything, but I came over and sat on the edge of the table and watched them. So what happened, George, butter, okay, slice of butter was there. What he put his, foot over it. And ultimately he said, I didn't said anything. Okay, he said that I came on the side of the table and sat there to watch the entire incident, that what they are doing. Sometimes watching is more happier than doing anything. Okay, and sat on the edge of the table and he watched them. It irritated them more than anything I could have said. And this really irritated me, because earlier also when George and Harris, they were sitting together, sprawling their legs, okay, by cocking their legs onto the table, and he was also irritated. And in the same manner, he said, they were also feeling irritated that why I was not saying anything, or I was not giving any opinion. Now you have to pack this, you have to pack that. I felt that. He felt this kind of irritation in their behavior. It made them nervous and excited. So what kind of feelings they were having? They were feeling quite nervous. Okay, nervous means, first of all, why they were feeling nervous? Because they were trying to prove themselves that we are best packers than you. And in order to prove themselves, they are doing the things wrong. Okay, and they were excited also. And they stepped on things and put things behind them, and then couldn't find them when they wanted them. And they packed the piles at the bottom, but heavy things on top, and smashed the pies in. So ultimately, they were quite nervous, and in excitement, what they were doing, they were putting the things behind. They were looking around through the whole room. Where is it? Where is it? Where is it? And finally, what the narrator was doing, he was just laughing. Okay, he was just, you can say, he was just giggling to see whatever they were doing. And the worst thing that they have done is that is the pies, which is very soft one. They have put heavy things over it so that they can be pressed and lost all, you can say, taste and all. So they upset salt over everything, means they spilled salt over everything. Mean maybe you can say packet of salt maybe there, or it can be a small, you can say, sprinkling small bottle, and salt was everywhere. Okay, because may not they have covered it with some lead, and it has been spilled over everything. And as for the butter, I never saw two men do more than with 1 and 2 pence worth of butter in my whole life than they did. Means with a very small amount of butter, he said what they have done, that was really worth to watch. Because he said, in my entire life, I haven't ever seen that this kind of thing can also be done with butter. See what they have done. Mainly the question, whenever subjective is there, so it can be asked, for example, explain the butter incident. So see what they have done. Okay, so what they have done. After George had got it off his slipper, they tried to put it in the kettle. So finally, when they have got off his slipper, they tried to put butter in the kettle. It wouldn't go in. And what was in wouldn't come out. And what was already there in the kettle, it was not coming out. But obvious, because it has a narrow mouth from where the things can be taken out. They did scrape it out at last and put it down on a chair, and Harry sat on it. Finally, they scrape it with the help of some spoon or some ladle. They have taken it out of kettle and put it on the chair. And now what happened? Put it on chair. Harris was so tired, or he was so excited, that he sat on the butter. Now what will happen? Butter will stuck at its back? No. And they went looking for it all over the room. Butter was behind Harris, and they were moving all over the room. Where is butter? Where is butter? They were fighting with each other. Imagine the situation. Abhi to maine yahan rakha tha. I had just put it here. Now they were just looking it around through the entire room. Where is butter? Where is butter? And this is what they have done. I'll take my oath. I put it down on that chair, George said, staring at an empty seat. He looked at the seat that, yes, I have kept it there. He said, I swear, I have kept it here. But who has taken it? Now see, I saw you do it myself not a minute ago, said Harris. Harris said, yes, even I have seen that you have put the butter there, but where it has gone? He did not know it is stuck at his back. Then they started round the room again looking for it. And then they met again in the center and stared at one another. So they were moving in the four corners of the room, here, there. Finally, they were looking around all the things. Finally, they again came in the center of the room, and they were saying, where the butter has gone? We have placed it here. This happens with us also. When everything is so messed up, then we, like, for example, you people are doing the chart work. Sometimes when there is so much of burden of completion to meet the, you can say, targeted time, you are so burdened up. Tabhi aisa hota hai na, abhi to maine yahan rakha tha, ye kahan gaya, and finally when the work is over, you will find it again. Aisa hi hota hai na? This is common thing. This happens with all. This often happens with me also. Sometimes it happens that I place it. This often happens with me. I place it on the table, then I will look and look around where I have kept it. So finally, I saw you do it myself not a minute ago. Then they started round the room and looking for it, and then they met again in the center and stared at one another. Most extraordinary thing I ever heard of, said George. So mysterious, Harry said. He said, now see their astonishment, their surprise. He said, oh my God, this is the most extraordinary thing that I have ever not noticed, that we have placed the thing here, and where it has gone, somebody must have taken it. So Harris was saying, yes, so mysterious, where it has gone. So finally, why here it is all the time, he exclaimed indignantly. Where, called Harry, spinning around. Stand still, can't you, roared George, flying after him. He said, oh my God, I did not know that it was there. Harry said, where? He said, just turn around. And he has shown him that it was sticking at his back. So are they got it off and packed it in the teapot? And they got it off and finally they have packed it in the teapot. So till here the butter incident is over. So this chapter, or see this is the greatness of the writer, what the story is about and how he has taken it towards humorous element, right? So much of humor is there, so much of fun is there that you people are enjoying, right? So packing is not, we can say it is, you can say useless activity, but it requires a lot of skill also. It requires a lot of, you can say, capability also. You can say complete planning in order to do it. A person will always feel that it is a frivolous or it is mundane, means a thing of no importance or insignificant activity. But no, it was not. It demands your skills. And this is what the writer is going to deliver to us. And this three men in a boat, it is just, you can say, they are trying and they have started for, they are to start for a journey, and what they were doing in between. The entire, you can say, this novel is about that. If you will ever get a time, just go to library, have your copy issued and read it. Okay? Right? And that will be quite beneficial for you also. Okay? Otherwise, I have a copy of it. If you people want, I will give it to you. Okay? Right? So you can read it in your free time. Right? So understood now chapter? Okay? And in the next class, we will do further, because next afterwards in the next part of the chapter, we are going to study about, or we are going to, we get to know about another main character of this family, that is Montmorency, who is the dog of the family. Okay, he is also of the same type of nature as George and Harris, adding more chaos to the ordered things. Means until and unless the chaos is not created, he says that my day is not fulfilled. Okay, so this is all about for today, and next we will continue.